This is actually just a case that we did very recently. Thank you, Danielle. And it just illustrates, I think we were awake during the operation, which is the good thing. Okay, so this is kind of a busy slide, and I have to explain to you why. It's a patient that we did a two-level ALIF on, a patient I've taken care of for a lot of years, operated on his neck a couple times for different problems, his back a couple times, and anyway, he came to have a fusion after about knowing him 17 years and four or five operations later. So we did an ALIF at two levels, all went fine. We turned him over. I think my biggest complication is that Terry Kim was not there to help me with the MIS part of this operation, of which he's the ultimate expert at. And I said, I don't need Terry to do this. I can do this with the residents and the fellows, so I'm okay. But this shows, where's a pointer? It's killing. Pointer's not working. Okay. So the right side pedicle screw that's going in is going in well. This shows that there are wires and screws in, which you never see that in real life. So this was after something had gone wrong and we'd already put a screw in. So this is the second CT scan that illustrates what the problem was, or we were figuring out what the problem was. But the right side, everything went well. I don't have too many slides here. There are just two, actually. But you can see the wire in the middle, and it's kind of hard to show all of these, but they were all good on the right side. So when we went to the left side, is that something didn't feel right, okay? Is that there was not a bony resistance that you have when you put a pedicle screw in, and it has that crunchy feel down the middle of the pedicle, and the surgeons that put pedicle screws in know this very well. But something didn't feel right with this wire. Okay, it felt like it was in soft tissue. In fact, then another one felt like it was actually maybe in a disc space or something like that. So sure enough, what we did is I left all the wires in, said, let's just get another intraoperative CT scan, and it showed that somewhere between right side, which we did the beginning of the operation on the left side, is that everything on the left side was off, just a phase shift out of the pedicle at each level. I have no idea why, because they were actually not symmetric like that case that Dr. Kim just showed. So I don't even have an answer for this one. But it's one of these things that having a level of suspicion and concern, if something just doesn't feel right, have a low threshold to go back and redo everything. So that's where I come up with this. And it's like, okay, perfect one side, bad on the other side. And I'm not sure I understand why. Something happened. And it comes back to one simple thing. Navigation errors. Registration, I think it's kind of like, you know, when your phone quits and you have to just hot boot it. Sometimes you have, there are computer errors that occur, but otherwise it works incredibly well. Okay, the errors that really are the problem, they're the reference frame most often, but the biggest problems are really the last ones, the surgeon. Okay, because it comes down to the operator. Okay, it's operator error. Okay, everything else here, in theory, works incredibly well if it's done right. If you put it in a laboratory, you put it on a bench, you put it on saw bones, everything works. But the surgeon is the one who has to have the brain, okay? And it's like when you're flying in an airplane. You want the pilot, who usually uses a computer to land the airplane, but if the computer's not working, the pilot has to look out the window, okay, and be able to land the airplane. That's my analogy for this, so. I just wanted to share this one with you. I do have another one, but I'll show it later.